Hello, good morning, my dear student. Purely resistive circuit with single phase AC circuit. Let us consider purely resistance across a single phase AC supply as shown below figure. Here, R is represented as a purely resistance and small v is equals to Vm sin omega t is represent as a instantaneous voltage or applied voltage. Whenever this instantaneous voltage is applied across the purely resistive circuit, then small amount of, or we can say some amount of current will be flow. That current is considered instantaneous current I. Now applied voltage V is equals to Vm sin omega t. It is considered as equation number 1, where small v is represent instantaneous voltage and Vm is represent as a maximum voltage. Now our aim to find the relation between instantaneous voltage and instantaneous current, then we know that by Ohm's law I is equals to V by R. It is considered as equation number 2. Now substitute the value of instantaneous voltage in equation number 2, then we get I is equals to Vm by sin omega t upon R. This is considered as equation number 3, or here small I is represented as a instantaneous current. Whenever here we are putting omega is equals to 0 or omega t is equals to 30, then we get instantaneous amount of current. This instantaneous amount of current may be become maximum when omega t is equals to put 90 degree, or sin omega t is equals to when sin omega t is equals to 1. Now for the making of this instantaneous current become as a maximum current, in equation number 3 put omega t is equals to 90 or sin omega t is equals to 1. When substitute omega t is equals to 90, then we get this instantaneous current become maximum current and I max is equals to V max by R, and this is considered as equation number 4. Now from equation number 3 and equation number 4, we can say I instantaneous is equals to I max into sin omega t, or it is considered as equation number 5. Now compare equation number 1 and equation number 5. Equation number 1 is related to applied voltage and equation number 5 is related to current flowing through the purely resistive circuit. When we are comparing the equation number 1 and equation number 2, then small letter of V is represent as an instantaneous voltage and small letter of I is represent as a instantaneous current of the circuit, and Vm is represent as a maximum voltage of applied voltage, maximum voltage of the circuit, and Im is represent the maximum amount of current in the circuit. From equation number 1 and equation number 5, we can say ki no phase difference between instantaneous voltage and instantaneous current. It means the phase difference between voltage and current is zero. It means the phase difference between applied voltage or current flowing through the circuit is zero. So we can draw the phasor diagram. So phasor diagram as shown, I and V are having in same phase. After drawing the phasor diagram, we will discuss about waveform diagram. We know that we are considering applied voltage. The nature of applied voltage is sinusoidal. So V is sinusoidal nature, and similarly due to this applied voltage current will be flow. So the nature of current is also sinusoidal, but no phase difference between applied voltage and current, applied voltage and current. So voltage and current are having in same phase. Now obtain the instantaneous power. Power, we know that power, it means the product of voltage and current is known as power. Whenever we are finding the power, first multiply the voltage and current in terms of electrical domain. Now here we want to find the instantaneous power. It means the product of instantaneous current and instantaneous voltage. So instantaneous power is equals to P is equals to I into V, where I is a instantaneous current and V is a instantaneous voltage. Now substitute the value of instantaneous voltage and instantaneous current from equation number 1 and equation number 5. Then we get P is equals to Vm sin omega t, Im sin omega t and Vm sin omega t. Now sin omega t into sin omega t is become sin square omega t. We know that sin square omega t is equals to 1 minus cos 2 omega t by 2. Now Vm into Im by 2 is equals to in bracket 1 minus cos 2 omega 2 cos 2 omega t. Now Vm by 2 is written as root 2 into root 2. Then we can say Im by root 2 into Vm by root 2. And this Im by root 2 and Vm by root 2 is considered as I RMS and V RMS. And in bracket having 1 minus cos 2 omega t. This I RMS into V RMS multiply with 1 minus cos 2 omega t. Then we get instantaneous power is equals to VRMS into IRMS minus VRMS into IRMS into cos 2 omega t. Cos 2 omega t. This is considered as part 1 and part 2. Part 1 is represent independent of time factor, and part 2 is represent as a dependent factor of time, because here having cos 2 omega t. Cos 2 omega t. Whenever we are finding the average power, that conditions this instantaneous power integrate with 0 to 2 pi. Whenever we are integrate 0 to 2 pi, integration of 0 to 2 pi cos 2 omega t into d omega t, then we get 0. It means the average power of purely resistive circuit is VRMS into IRMS. And also we will discuss about the power waveform diagram. We know that the current and voltage having no phase, it means now we know that instantaneous power, it means product of voltage into product of current. So in this waveform, the voltage is positive, current is positive. So the power waveform is also positive. In second half cycle, or we can say after half cycle, current is negative and voltage is negative, and negative into negative become positive. The power is positive. After finding the instantaneous power, we will discuss about power factor. Power factor, it means nothing as it is a angle between voltage and current. The angle between voltage and current is considered as a power factor, or cosine angle of voltage and current is known as power factor. It is denoted by cos phi or power factor. In purely resistive circuit, power factor is unity, because the purely resistive circuit no phase difference between voltage and current. So cos phi is equals to unity power factor. After discussing about power factor, we will move on to phase angle. Phase angle, it means the angle between in applied voltage and current flowing through the circuit. We know that in purely resistive circuit, the voltage and current having in same phase, it means no phase difference between voltage, applied voltage and current flowing through the purely resistive circuit. It means phase angle become 0, and phase angle is represented by phi. Phase angle is represented by phi.